Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Heather Sells. We could know later today whether BP has finally landed on a solution to stop the oil gushing into the Gulf. Engineers using robotic instruments cut the leaking pipe and placed a cap on it. But BP makes no guarantees that this cap will work. Charlene Israel has more from the newsroom.
BP hopes this latest attempt to stop the flow of oil in the Gulf will work, but they say it's too early to tell. Robots a mile beneath the Gulf of Mexico positioned a funnel-like lid over the main pipe of the leaking well. If the cap is successful, the oil will be siphoned to a tanker on the surface. But the gushing oil makes it difficult to tell if the cap is working.
It's an important milestone, and in some senses, of course, it's just the beginning.
The hope is that the weight of the new 5,000-foot steel pipeline will force the cap tightly over the uneven pipe. But after 6 weeks and numerous failures, no one is making any predictions.
There is always risk. The risk is reduced, but there is still risk as to whether or not it will be fully successful.
Today, President Obama will return to the Gulf for his third visit since the crisis began. There is also speculation that he will delay his trip to Indonesia to deal with the spill. In an interview with CNN's Larry King, he expressed his frustration over the situation.
This is an example of where somebody didn't think through the consequences of their actions.
Meanwhile, the oil has now begun to affect wildlife in the Gulf Coast wetlands.
What we're concerned about is not only this bird, but the future. That's why it's so important for us not to allow this oil to get in these wetlands.
The oil is expected to reach the Florida panhandle within days, and a computer model shows that it could wind up in the East Coast by July. Reporting from the newsroom, I'm Charlene Israel.
Thanks, Charlene. McDonald's is recalling about 12 million drinking glasses today. The 16-ounce glasses have a painted design from the new movie Shrek to promote it. They're being recalled because the paint contains a toxic metal called cadmium. Cadmium is a carcinogen that's been found to cause weak bones and severe kidney problems. There's concern that children using the glasses may not wash their hands after using them, and long-term exposure to the paint could cause it to leach into the body. Another cargo ship is approaching the Gaza coast with the intent to run the Israeli blockade. It's expected to arrive this afternoon. Israeli officials have identified many of the people who took part in the first attempt as Islamic radicals. They say the Freedom Flotilla is just one more attempt to destroy the Jewish state. Here's Chris Mitchell from Jerusalem.
They declared the army of Muhammad was coming, hoped for martyrdom, and some even prepared their wills. Was the Freedom Flotilla a humanitarian mission or a radical Islamic plot?
This is an effort to delegitimize the state of Israel and deny it its fundamental rights. What Israel engaged in was a legal blockade of a terrorist entity. Blockades are used by the British, by the U.S., by many countries who are engaged in war, and Hamas, which controls the Gaza Strip, is at war with the state of Israel, calls for its destruction, launches Iranian rockets at our civilians.
The way Israel conducted this raid will be debated for years by Israel and others. But some believe a larger question transcends the military tactics. They see this as a battle between radical Islam and the West. One Israeli professor put it this way: "The time has come to tell those who live near and far that this battle is not just about the Middle East. Rather, it is a fight for the face of this world. At this time, Israel is located at a frontal outpost. In the huge struggle against the Islamic forces that threaten to take over the world and subjugate it to their green flag. Israel may be on the front lines, but the U.S. is right behind. Case in point, the Times Square bombing attempt is just the latest narrow escape in the U.S. from a potentially devastating terror attack. And some warn radical Muslims are using a less visible, more subtle, and possibly more dangerous tactic than blatant terror. They warn some Muslims are using the West's own system to infiltrate its way of life. They're trying to introduce Islamic Sharia law into Western court systems, banks, and its educational system. In effect, to bring in Islamic law by stealth. But whether it's by stealth or by terror, Israel and the West are facing a challenge to their way of life not seen since the Middle Ages. Some feel how Israel and the West respond to this challenge may well determine the future of Western civilization. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Back here at home, the White House is taking more heat for reports of backroom deals in two U.S. Senate races. And as John Waggie reports, the latest questions come from Colorado.
The Obama administration was apparently eager to make things easier for incumbent Senator Michael Bennet. So a top White House advisor contacted his challenger, fellow Democrat Andrew Romanoff, about getting out of the race.
He suggested three positions that might be available to me were I not to pursue a Senate race, and emailed me descriptions of those positions that day. I informed him that I was not going to change course.
The White House insists that there was no wrongdoing in the Colorado case, but it's been just days since the admission that President Obama's team sent former President Clinton to offer an unpaid federal job to Pennsylvania Democrat Joe Sestak if he would drop his primary challenge to Arlen Specter. It's a felony for a government official to promise a job for anything of value. Some Republicans called for a special investigation, but the request was denied by the Justice Department.
I can assure the public that nothing improper took place.
Legal or not, some say the backdoor dealing doesn't square with candidate Obama's promises of a new and more open style of politics. Chicago Sun-Times bureau chief Lynn Sweet says the deal-making issue will continue to plague the president.
I think first there will be a demand for more details and more background about what happened in the context that they happened. And I think the Republicans are going to be very forcefully trying to make this and keep this NICU.
John Waggie, CBN News.
The 21st anniversary of the Tiananmen Square crackdown passed in China today with little fanfare. China's government has never fully disclosed what happened when the military crushed months of student-led protests on the nights of June 3rd and 4th, 1989. Possibly thousands of students and ordinary citizens were killed. Chinese Christians in the U.S. marked the anniversary with a prayer service outside of Washington, D.C. They say God used the tragedy for good.
What God has done over that tragedy is a huge revival among the Chinese students, intellectuals. There are hundreds of thousands, I mean millions, Chinese students and intellectuals came to know the Lord in every university in China now. There are Bible studies groups.
Some Chinese church leaders say there could be as many as 100 million Christians in China. Most worship in unregistered churches, which are outlawed by the government. Turning now to Haiti, where most of the survivors of the January earthquake are still waiting for help from their government. Some are finding help at a church where American relief organizations are offering support. Mercy Chefs arrived in Haiti not long after the quake, and it's not only helping to feed Haitian people, it is showing them how to put food on their own tables for years to come. Ephraim Graham is in Haiti with his story.
Chambre is a poor Haitian village home to 4,500 people. Hundreds of them begin their week walking to church, dressed in their Sunday best. And once they arrive, it's time to celebrate what's been taking shape inside their hearts and to forget about January's deadly earthquake.
I can either see the problem and complain about it, or I can become proactive and say, let me do something about it.
Pastor Esperandu Pierre is founder of Nehemiah Vision Ministries, a church, school, and health center to serve the people of Chambray.
Poor people doesn't need to hear Christ, about Christ. They want to feel, they want to hear the demonstration of the gospel through the act of love.
The latest act of love for the people of Chambray is coming from Mercy Chefs, a disaster relief organization the American chef Gary LeBlanc started 4 years ago with four simple words from God. Just go feed people.
What happened to make Mercy Chefs decide that responding to disaster in America wasn't enough, you were coming to Haiti?
The images on TV were too familiar to me. They took me right back to the days after Hurricane Katrina. And we just felt compelled to come.
Global Aid Network, the international arm of Campus Crusade for Christ, is building a new dining hall. And Mercy Chefs is adding a state-of-the-art kitchen.
You guys are doing a great job, man. I mean, last time I was here, it was just a flat piece of concrete. No walls, no ceiling.
The building project is employing Haitians who need jobs. And when it's done, there'll be a bakery to employ even more.
We're going to find a pastry chef or master baker to come in and teach how to do the bakery here.
That would be awesome.
Until now, the campus cook has used this pot over an outdoor flame to prepare daily meals for hundreds.
When Mercy Chefs come to Haiti and is helping the people that are ministering to us, that is the greatest message we need to hear and to see. Sometimes you can touch the message, sometimes you can hear it, and we need both.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, Chambray, Haiti.
Thanks, Ephraim. If you would like to help relief groups at work in Haiti, including CBN's Operation Blessing, just visit our website. The link is cbnnews.com. 1 million evangelicals in Brazil rallied for the annual March for Jesus event in Sao Paulo. This year marked the 18th March. It is an event that unites evangelicals in the world's largest Roman Catholic country. Sao Paulo is one of the world's largest cities with over 10 million residents. In recent decades, evangelical churches have grown rapidly there to become a major influence. Coming up in the UK, a street preacher is arrested and jailed. You won't believe the reason why.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith.
Amazing love, how can it be?
Get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only
$24.99. Here I am to worship. Here I am.
But wait. Order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just
$9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Publicly sharing your Christian beliefs in the United Kingdom could land you in jail. That is what happened to a street preacher in the northwest of England recently. Now he's taking the police to court, and he is speaking out for the first time about his arrest and right to free speech.
Christian street preacher Dale McAlpine was thrown in a prison cell last month for publicly objecting to homosexuality. McAlpine from Workington in Cumbria was arrested following a conversation with a police officer in which McAlpine said the Bible calls homosexual conduct a sin. The arrest incident was captured on a hidden camera.
Homophobia is hatred towards homosexuals. That's the definition of homophobia, but I'm not a homophobia. I spoke to the officer earlier, and he was upset that I was saying homosexuality was a sin, which is what the Bible says. And I affirm that's what I say, because that's in the Bible, you know. I mean, there's no law.
He was preaching publicly in the town on the 20th of April this year, but he insists he never spoke about the subject of homosexuality during his public sermon.
Well, when I got up onto my stepladder to preach, I never mentioned homosexual conduct. I mentioned a number of other sins like drunkenness, adultery, and blasphemy, but I never once mentioned the sin of homosexuality while I was preaching.
He was then arrested and held in a cell overnight here at Workington Police Station. McAlpine told CBN News he was in complete shock to find himself locked up simply for sharing his beliefs.
Well, I was shocked that I was taken off the streets. I didn't expect to be in a prison cell that day. I went out to preach the gospel. And I was shocked that I found myself in a cell and my freedom taken away from me. Yet I had a wonderful peace from the Lord. The Lord gave me peace and I had my Bible.
4 days after McAlpine pled not guilty to the charge, the Crown Prosecution Service dropped the case due to insufficient evidence. Cumbria Police were unable to comment on the case, but in a statement, Chief Superintendent Steve Johnson said, "We'd like to reassure the public that we respect and are committed to upholding the fundamental rights to freedom of expression. We're just as committed to maintaining the peace and preventing people feeling alarmed or distressed by the actions of others in public places." The Christian Institute helped McAlpine with his legal defense. Spokesman Simon Calvert says the police must be held responsible for their actions.
Cumbria Police can't just walk away from this. They've arrested and charged an innocent man for no other reason than that he peacefully expressed his Christian beliefs. And it's happened in other parts of the country too, so there's clearly a problem with this system and it has to be put right.
But while many cases like this continue across the UK, Christians remain deeply concerned that their ability to openly express their beliefs in this country are increasingly under threat. Peter Wooding for CBN News, Cumbria, England.
Ted Haggard is starting a new church. The former pastor also once headed the National Association of Evangelicals. He resigned after admitting to an affair with a gay prostitute. Haggard made the announcement about his new church Wednesday with his family.
Though many believe that I am not qualified, nor will I ever be qualified again to be a pastor, that because of what we've been through, I may be qualified to help other people in need.
Haggard's new church will be in Colorado Springs. Up next, new research shows that singles who are sexually active regret it after marriage.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Welcome back. More than 40% of unmarried American teens say they have had sex. A new study from the U.S. National Center for Health Statistics reports that 4.3 million teens have had sex at least once. The trend has flattened out since the last two decades when teen pregnancy was in a decline. Even more surprising, 1 in 5 teen girls and 1 in 4 teen boys who've had sex said they would actually be pleased if pregnancy resulted from the act. The report also found that about one quarter of female teens and 29% of males claim to have had multiple partners. Sexual permissiveness is common in America today, but new scientific research says that people who are sexually active now may regret it after they get married. Here's reporter Paul Strand.
Imagine if science could prove sleeping around in your youth could ruin your chances of having a happy, fulfilling marriage later. That's what Dr. Joe McElhaney of the Medical Institute for Sexual Health in Austin says new research shows.
Neuroscientists have produced a lot of information just in the past few years. This is new.
And he reveals in the book, Hooked,
the most modern neuroscience available to man today.
Research using brain scans now shows powerful chemicals are released during sex that should create a powerful, everlasting bond. For women,
their brain secretes oxytocin that causes them to bond emotionally to that man. Men secrete a hormone called vasopressin when they're having that kind of intimate behavior, and it bonds them to the woman.
This oxytocin is so overwhelming in a woman's brain that just a 20-second hug can cause a female to become bonded to a male. A 20-second hug. Both sexes get addictive doses of dopamine as well during intimate behavior, which does work well for couples out to create lifelong marriages and stable families.
They're addicted to sex and babies result from that.
But that bonding, which acts like adhesive tape or Velcro, is weakened when people tear away at its power by breaking off with a sexual partner and moving on from one to another to another. So when it does finally come time to bond permanently with a spouse, the ability to bond is damaged.
The brain actually gets molded to not accept that deep emotional level that's so important for marriage.
One huge result of this for the permissive?
When they do marry, they're more likely to have a divorce than people that were virgins when they got married.
Across much of the culture, this big scientific news isn't known and certainly isn't much communicated to youth who these days live in a sexual Wild West. Teen evangelist Jeffrey Dean runs websites checked out by 250,000 youth every year. Thousands tell him they're pressured to be sexual and are often wounded by it.
Anything goes is the new rule. And in the process, kids are experimenting, but they're finding out there's great hurt and baggage along with that.
Dean says he hears all the time from kids who started having sex way too young about the effect these bonding chemicals in the brain have. They'll write,
"Well, this relationship didn't work, but I'm so emotionally attached to what happened there. I'm looking for that again, even if it means making choices that I don't even want to make or that I know are against God's will for my life."
McElhaney says the long-term harm from ripping away at that bonding is bad enough, but he points out research also shows damaging this chemical bonding in the brain can hurt young people now.
If adolescents are sexually involved, they're more likely to be suicidal than their friends who are not sexually involved. Girls are 3 times as likely to be suicidal. Boys are 7 times as likely to be suicidal as their friends that are still virgins.
Such research is why McElhaney pleads with parents to counsel kids to stay abstinent. He also says parents must realize it's a much more dangerous world sexually today than when they were young.
Only about 1 in 50 kids, for example, had a sexually transmitted disease back in the 60s. Today, 1 in 4 of all adolescents has a sexually transmitted disease.
And one more young person gets an STD every 4 seconds. Dean can't shake from his mind a note he got from a young woman who'd only slept with one guy.
She went on to college, and 3 years after the sexual relationship from high school, she had not had another sexual partner, and she found out that she was HIV positive from this guy. 3 years later.
McElhaney has one more big piece of news from brain scan research. Maturing in the brain is shown here in blue. The research shows the prefrontal cortex, where wise decisions and judgments are made, doesn't fully mature until the mid-20s.
So it's impossible, because the brain tissue is not there in a mature way, for kids to make fully mature decisions. We're talking to 24, 25, 26, before the brain is really mature.
So McElhaney and Dean both insist parents have to guide and keep guiding their young people. Dean says they actually want it.
Students tell us overwhelmingly at the top of the list, the greatest influence in my life is mom and dad.
In his book, The Fight of Your Life, Dean says parents should explicitly state to their kids they expect them to remain abstinent and back it up with scripture, like 1 Corinthians 6:18.
Flee from sexual immorality. We know God is saying here, listen, don't even dance around it. Don't even get near it.
And McElhaney points out you now have science of the brain to back you up.
The science proves that human beings are made to be monogamous for life with one other person in a faithful relationship. It is the way human beings are made.
Dean says just make sure you back up your demands with solid support.
My teens need to see from me that I am approachable and that I am unshockable.
And no matter how badly a young person might fail, they should know
mom and dad are going to have my back.
Paul Strand, CBN News.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new do's. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new, or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Finally today, a show of grace from the pitcher denied a perfect game by an imperfect call. You know the story by now. Detroit pitcher Armando Galarraga was on his way to a perfect game with just one out to go in the ninth, but a split-second call from the umpire cost him a place in baseball history. Here's the play and the apology.
And there's nobody that feels worse than I do.
He apologized and he feel really bad. Only when you see him, you say, oh my God, he feel really bad. You know, that don't happen. You don't see an umpire tell after the game and say, hey, let me tell you, I'm sorry. It's not happen, really.
Joyce's apology is rare in the baseball world. Major League Baseball rules grant the commissioner the authority to reverse the call, but Commissioner Bud Selig is refusing to do so. Well, that's all for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find information on all the stories that you've seen here at cbnnews.com. And you can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day.
Hi, I'm Terry Meeson. I'd like to tell you about Orphans Promise. Orphans Promise helps children who've had tragic beginnings in life.
My father died, my mother started drinking, and gave me away to the orphanage.
We were homeless, and she made me beg for food.
We don't know where our sister is. I'm looking for her now.
We want to return to be with our mother, but she doesn't want us.
In many countries, children are turned out of orphanages when they turn 16. They lose the only security they've ever known. Many will become easy prey for prostitution rings and criminal gangs. Together, you and I can break this cycle for these kids. For just $20 a month, you'll provide computer training, life skills, and people that care, preparing them for a future of hope. Show them God's love. Call the number on your screen right now and say you'll help.
Finding video on CBN.com just got easier. We've taken all our video, the 700 Club, news, testimonies, teachings, plus our 24/7 channels, and put them in one convenient location, CBN TV. Watch what you want, when you want. It's all simple to find, and now easier than ever to email a story to a friend. CBN TV on CBN.com.